Hi, Chuck Huber here for the Stata YouTube channel. Today I'd like to show you how to download and install Stata. After you purchase Stata, you should receive an email that looks like this. About midway down, you'll see some instructions that say to install Stata. So step one is to download Stata. So I'm going to click this link that says download.stata.com. When I click this, this will take me to the download website. So next the website will prompt me to enter the username and password. Those can be found back in the email where it says username and password right underneath the download link. So I'm going to copy these to the web browser and paste them. And then go back and get the password. Copy that. Paste that. And now I'm going to click this button that says log in. Okay, now I'm at the Stata software download webpage. So the next thing I need to do is choose which platform or operating system that I want to download Stata for. I'm using Windows, so I'm going to select Windows, but you could select Mac or Linux if you want. So I'm going to click where it says Windows, and next it says 64-bit Windows installation instructions. So I'm going to download. I'm going to click this link where it next to download, where it says setup Stata 16.exe. So I'm going to click this. And I'll be prompted to save that executable file somewhere. So I'm going to click Save File. And I'm just going to save it in the default Downloads folder. So I'm going to click Save. And if I come up here, I'm using Firefox. So I'm going to click this little arrow. And then click where it says Show All Downloads. And Stata has the executable file has been downloaded locally to my Downloads folder. So I can either double click this, or if I go to my Downloads folder, I'll see the executable file here. So the next thing to do is run this executable. So I'm going to double click this, where it says setup Stata 16.exe. And you may be prompted, if you're not the administrator of your computer, your account, then you may need to enter a password or something. I'm just going to click yes, I'd like to install Stata. So now it's going to take me through the process. So I'm just going to follow the instructions as it prompts me along the way. Okay, it says, welcome to the Install Shield Wizard for Stata 16. I'm not going to read all of this to you, but I'm just going to click Next. This is the licensing agreement. I highly recommend that you read it. I'm not going to read it to you in this video, but I am going to click I accept the terms in the license agreement and then click Next. I can give this a username, so I'm going to type my name here. I'm Chuck Huber, and my organization is Stata Corp. And I'm going to select Only For Me, root, and then click Next. And then I need to choose the flavor of Stata that I purchased. So in this case, I purchased Stata SE, so I'm going to select that. If you purchased Stata MP, you'll select that, or if you purchased Stata IC, you'll select that, but I'm doing Stata SE. So I'm going to click Next. And then it's asking me for the destination folder. In this case, the destination on my machine is C:\Program Files/Stata16. You can change that if you like, but I'm just going to leave it at the default and click Next. And then I'm prompted for the default working directory. So my choices are to use each user's documents folder, or I can use a fixed folder. I'm going to set this up to use each user's documents folder and then click Next. And now it tells me it's ready to install the program. So I'm going to click Install. And Stata is going to show me the status while it's installing. It tells me that this may take several minutes. And so in the interest of time, I don't think you want to watch this down or install for a couple of minutes. I'm going to use the magic of video editing to speed up this process a bit. Okay, and Install Shield says that the installation is completed. So I'm going to click the button here that says Finish. And now Stata is installed on my machine. So I can find Stata, my new installation of Stata 16, by clicking on the Start menu and scrolling down to Stata 16, and I'm going to click Stata SE 16. And I'm just going to click yes here where it says Data Administrative Tools. So now it's prompting me for my name, my organization, the serial number, and the code and authorization. Let me start by typing in my name. And my organization is Stata Corp. And now I need a serial number, a code, and an authorization. So let's go back to the original email that we got from Stata. And if we notice, there are two attachments here at the bottom. So I'm going to click this arrow. One of them is an invoice. The other will have a code number. It'll look like a long number .pdf. So I'm going to open this PDF file. And this will show me my serial number, my code, and my authorization. Now, a couple of things, and I've blocked these out because these are real codes, and I don't want to obviously put these on YouTube. A couple of things to notice before you type these in or copy them. One of the common issues is that L, the letter L, looks a lot like the number 1. And so be careful when you're typing these not to mistake an L for a 1. The other common issue is that the lowercase letter O looks like a 0. So just be careful what's a 0 and what's an O and what's an L and what's a 1 as you're entering these. So I'm going to copy the serial number from serial number in my PDF file, and I'm going to paste that into my initialize license box here. So I'm going to paste that, and then I'm going to go back and get the code. Whoops. And copy the code into my initialize license window. And lastly, I'm going to grab the authorization. So I'm going to copy and paste that to my initialize license window. And now everything is in, and I'm going to click next. And it says, would you like to register your copy of Stata now? So I'm going to go ahead and do that and click finish. Okay, after a moment, Stata will open. Okay, and now I'm going to go to the registration site. This will automatically take me to the Stata product registration website. And so if I scroll down here, I can see it's already filled in my name, my organization. For your department or field, you can select those from a list. Mine would be biostatistics, which is right here. And I can put in my email and confirmation email and so forth. Another thing that I can do is I can check some boxes here to receive emails regarding the following. So if I'd like to receive emails about new releases of Stata or free webinars or other things, I can select those here. Okay. And then I can go back to Stata, and I am ready to use Stata. So I hope this was helpful. Thanks for stopping by.